And Greg is here to tell you a little bit about the forecast. Not too bad this morning, Greg.
No, not bad at all. Good morning, Krista. Good morning, everyone, and a happy Friday to you. Let's start with a look at your temperatures. 56 degrees right now at Midland International, 61 in Big Spring, 53 down to Fort Stockton. You see Alpine just updated there to 57 degrees, 39 over to Marfa, and 45 degrees, even 46 for locations like Pecos and Hobbs. So cooler over the western counties, warmer over the east. Look at that, 61 to 63 at Big Spring and San Angelo. That's where you have a very strong wind in place this morning. Now, as we move into the afternoon, we will see a little bit of an increase in your temperature, also an increase in sunshine and a decrease in the winds that are so strong this morning. Let's highlight that for you in your day planner. We're starting this morning. Again, right now you're at 56. You'll probably drop to around 54, 55 under partly cloudy skies to begin the day. A south wind at around 10 to 20 miles per hour. We'll see 77 around lunchtime, mostly sunny skies, southwest winds 5 to 15 as we move into the middle of the day, and afternoon highs will top out in the upper 80s under sunny skies, west winds kicking in around 5 to 15 miles an hour. Now look at the big picture. You'll see low pressure setting up shop near the Texas Panhandle. A warm front extends out over Oklahoma. Our dry line extends down to the south and east of this, and then you have a cold front kicking across New Mexico. So all of this sets the stage for some active weather to our east across portions of central Texas near the I-35 corridor all the way back up into the Panhandle. Severe thunderstorms, a likely scenario along this frontal boundary up across portions of Oklahoma and north Texas. And then colder air wraps around the backside of this system behind this frontal boundary, and that'll arrive here around midnight, 11 p.m. to 1 a.m. That's when I think you'll see the front roll through, and you'll see westerly winds become northerly winds as this front passes through the region. Now, for today, I think most of your rainfall will be blown east of the area. Just don't see us getting much in the way of precipitation, but by Saturday evening into Sunday, you'll start to see rain chances ramping back up again. In the wake of that frontal boundary, you'll see temperatures running about 10 degrees cooler tomorrow, between 5 and 10 degrees cooler from one day to the next, depends on location. It looks like 80 degrees is what we'll bounce back to on Sunday. Monday as well, we'll see highs in the lower 80s and even warmer temperatures in the offing on Tuesday. It does look like rain chances could be somewhat decent, you know, in that neighborhood of 20 to 40%, depending on time and location, starting Saturday evening, again, continuing at least into Monday evening, maybe even Tuesday morning, depending on how long that storm system hangs out.